Hi everyone, and welcome to your daily devotional for Tuesday, May 5th, 2020. My name is Lee Benish, and I am the pastor of Hill United Presbyterian Church in Butler, Pennsylvania. And my hope is that this video will provide for you a brief opportunity to be in prayer and in scripture. Our prayers today come from a resource called Let Us Pray, Reformed Prayers for Christian Worship. It is a publication of Geneva Press. Take a moment and center yourself, and let us prepare to be in God's presence. We begin today by turning to Psalm 100, and this reading and all of the readings today come from the Common English Bible Translation. Listen now for God's word to us. Shout triumphantly to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with celebration. Come before him with shouts of joy. Know that the Lord is God. He made us. We belong to him. We are his people, the sheep of his own pasture. Enter his gates with thanks. Enter his courtyards with praise. Thank him. Bless his name. Because the Lord is good. His loyal love lasts forever. His faithfulness lasts generation after generation. Let us pray. God of harmony and light, help us to see your loving plan for our lives. Comfort those of us who mourn. Give us patience and courage to wait for your harvest, when what we have sown in tears we will reap with joy. Give us the vision to see your presence in our lives. You have done great things for us. Open our hearts to know your goodness. Amen. Our Old Testament reading today comes from the prophet Ezekiel, chapter 34, verses 23 through 31. Listen for God's word. I will appoint for them a single shepherd, and he will feed them. My servant David will feed them. He will be their shepherd. I, the Lord, will be their God, and my servant David will be their prince. I, the Lord, have spoken. I will make a covenant of peace for them, and I will banish the wild animals from the land. Then they will safely live in the desert and sleep in the forest. I will give them and those around my hill a blessing by sending the rain in its season. They will be rains of blessing. The trees in the fields will bear fruit, and the earth will yield its harvest. They will be safe on the fertile land, and they will know that I am the Lord when I break the bars of their yoke and deliver them from those who enslaved them. The nations will no longer prey on them, and wild animals will no longer devour them. They will live in safety, with no one to trouble them. I will establish for them a place famous for what it grows. No longer will they experience famine in the land, nor will they bear the disgrace of the nations. They will know that I, the Lord their God, am with them, and they, the house of Israel, are my people. This is what the Lord God says. You are my flock, the flock of my pasture. You are human, and I am your God. This is what the Lord God says. It says here that through the love and care of the shepherd, the people will know that they are God's people. How do you know that you belong to God? Our New Testament reading today comes from Hebrews chapter 13, verses 20 and 21. Listen once again for God's word. May the God of peace, who brought back the great shepherd of the sheep, our Lord Jesus, from the dead by the blood of the eternal covenant, equip you with every good thing to do his will, by developing in us what pleases him through Jesus Christ. To him be the glory forever and always. Amen. Friends, this is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. There's an old saying which says that God doesn't call the equipped, but equips the called. In what ways has God equipped you to do what you are called to do? Let us pray. Eternal and all-powerful God, we thank you for the covenant of love that binds us together. Even when we lose hope and turn away from you, you reach out to us. You make whole our brokenness. Even from the fragments of our lives, you weave a tapestry of great beauty. Nothing is impossible with you. You have prepared a place for us. Let us not rest until we find our way home and rest in you. Amen. Friends, may the Almighty God bless, preserve, and keep you this day and every day. Take care of yourself. I'll see you tomorrow.